Welcome back to Detroit Wants to Know. My guest this segment is Deandre Lipscomb, the Vice President of Community Outreach for HAP. Deandre, describe some of HAP's community outreach programs. What do you do?
Well, sure. I mean, HAP focuses in on really looking at the individual and creating personalized programs for the community at large. I mean, that's how we really differentiate ourselves from other competitors. You have our competitors that may write a check or give you a grant, but we really believe in grassroots mobilization. And what that means is actually going out in the community. And so we focus in on a key areas with our actual community outreach programs that can help really better the lives of those in the community.
So HAP's approach to community health is basically tailoring specific to the community.
That's correct. I mean, what we found is when you look at the issues facing the community at large, when you look at just looking at Detroit public schools or public schools in general and the lack of health education that is now because due to budget cuts and the like, you know, the kids are not getting the education that they need around health and nutrition. When we look at the rise in childhood as well as adult obesity, which is a cornerstone of our programs, that is an issue. And HAP views itself as a partner in the community, whether or not you have our coverage or not. Of course we want you to be a HAP member. There are benefits to being a HAP member, but we believe we have to be there as a pillar in the community and an advocate.
Okay, so what are some of the other major health challenges? You talked about childhood and adult obesity.
You have access to health and wellness options within urban areas. We know that's one a prime
just
issue there.
Itself.
Right. We need to look at the rise in chronic diseases. And some of that is stress related. I mean, when you look at, you know, not having a job and the economic conditions, that causes stress on the body, and that in turn turns into a lot of chronic diseases.
Okay. Let me continue here. How are they making a difference? Well, I mean, you talk about all this great stuff. How are HAP's programs making a difference?
Well, let me tell you a little bit more about our programs. And so our programs are really, we divide our programs up into community programs, which are public programs. We have programs for our actual members, so those who actually have HAP coverage. Mm-hmm. And then we have programs for the actual employer population, programs that we go on site and we conduct things such as health screenings. We conduct programs around weight. We conduct programs around health and nutrition education, and we conduct those at the actual work site. And so that's whether or not you have HAP coverage or not. But what we do for the community, we have a cornerstone program. So we have a program that we have that we've been running for years, and we have a partnership with the recreation centers across Metro Detroit to offer aquatic classes. And these classes have been geared towards moms and have been geared towards the actual seniors. And they come out and they do water aerobics. It's great exercise for them, a great way to burn calories. And once again, we've been doing that for years. We also have a program that's geared towards kids ages 8 to 13. It's called Ready, Set, Cook. And that's based on the philosophy from the American Pediatrics Association, the 5-2-1-0 model. And 5-2-1-0 basically stands for that basically you should have 5 fruits and vegetables a day. You should have only 2 hours of screen time, which is very challenging for kids because screen time is not only TV, it's time on your phone, it's time on your computer, but that is the recommendation, only 2 hours of screen time a day, 1 hour of physical activity, and then 0 sweetened beverages. So that's no Kool-Aid, no pop, anything like that, 0 sweetened
beverages. You sound
like
my good friend Big Lou. So no Coca-Cola. What about ribs in summertime?
What is this Coca-Cola is pop that keeps coming up in our conversation?
I've got one out in the car because that's how I get up for the show.
If it better not be in the car, you in the gym with me tomorrow.
That's why I got tinted windows.
No pop, no Coke.
Oh, who is he?
It's my personal trainer that threatened me on this show not to have any pop.
Really?
Yeah.
How have you done with that?
Just add one. Anyways, one more question. We're at Lipkey Rec Center today. One of your programs is here that we're going to hear about later.
Yes, this is one of our newest programs, and we're very proud of this program. It's with a partnership with the National Kidney Foundation, which is renowned in terms of looking at health and health outcomes. And that's one thing I want to say about our programs. We really look at outcomes. So it's not just implementing a program in the community, but it's also looking at the results. And this program is great. Program is called Enhance Fitness, and this program is primarily geared towards seniors, but they come in and they do a variety of different exercises, and there's multiple levels. So once they achieve the goals of one level, then they can accelerate to the next level. Very popular.
Okay, that's excellent. Deandre, before I let you go, how do people contact HAP to get involved in these programs?
The best way to find out about our programs or to contact us is to go to hap.org.
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 All right. I hope you can stick around and listen to the next interview. We've got somebody from the National Kidney Foundation coming
up.
Deandre, thanks for showing up today.
Thank you, Steve.
All right. Ladies and gentlemen, we'll be right back. And we're talking about kidneys.